A slap on the wrist. That's what a local family is saying about the punishment handed down to a driver who police say was looking at her phone instead of the road when she struck and killed a Port Orange woman in April.
The family says the driver got away with murder. WESH's Matt Grant live in Port Orange with more on why at least one legal expert disagrees. Matt.
Well, Martha, Jim, we're at Ridgewood Avenue and White Place in Port Orange, and it's right here at this four-lane highway where, according to police reports, 78-year-old Leanna Daniluk was struck and killed back in April by a distracted driver. But it's the way that driver was punished that has one family furious.
It's 9 a.m. April 11th. Surveillance video captures the moment Leanna Daniluk tried crossing this four-lane highway. We're not going to show you the impact, but according to police reports, Nicole Negrani was reaching for her phone when she ran into Daniluk.
She died instantly.
In that instant, Mike Melnikoff's life changed when he learned his mother-in-law was killed. He says it's still painful to be back in this spot.
It is hard because a loved one died here. I mean, this is basically her final resting place right there in the street.
On Monday, a judge slapped Negrani with a $1,000 fine, a 6-month license suspension, and 120 hours of community service.
Do you feel this was a fair punishment?
No. No, I think vehicular homicide would have been more suitable. I feel like she got away with murder.
Orlando attorney Richard Hornsby disagrees because he says this was just an accident and there was no criminal intent.
Accidents happen every day, and in order for an accident to rise to the level of crime, it has to be gross negligence. It has to border on the intentional act.
Intentional or not, Daniluk's daughter feels the punishment doesn't fit.
I think she should have got more than what she got.
Why do you think that?
Because my mom lost her life. It's devastating. It's heartbreaking.
We left a message for Negrani's attorney. We did not hear back. According to reports, though, he told the judge that his client was not reaching for a phone and that she failed to yield to traffic, so essentially blaming the victim. State Senator Darren Soto wants to change the law, though. He wants to make it a criminal offense that if you are driving and texting at the same time and that results in an accident and a death, that would be a criminal offense. For now, we're live in Port Orange. Matt Grant, WESH 2 News.